This video is going to be on God is the source of all love. No matter what happens, God is the source of all love. Before I do the introduction, God just really wanted me to stress that and really let you know that God is the source of all love, the source of all wealth, the source of all health, the source of all that we need in our lives. He is the source of what we do to create kids, to create a life, and to create families. God is the source of all. God is the source of love. With God being the source of all love, conviction is what creates in us to extend an unconditional love to others. Very important, before I start my video, this needs to be, you know, stressed and needs to be acknowledged. Conviction creates love, unconditional love, a love without pride. Everything that God created love to be. With conviction comes so much success in loving others and the way God called us to love on others. This is something that God wanted me to really, really, really say before I introduce the word for today and what got me to this point of everything, which is conviction. I pray that you wake with much conviction every day to love on others as the way God called us to love on others. You'll be convicted as to love others the way God calls us to. I'm in prayers for this. Hola, Reisirinas. I pray that you wake with so much love in your heart, so much peace, and always with that expectancy of God's love. And especially with Love Month approaching, that you really, really recognize like love and that you feel loved. And if you don't feel loved in the physical, that you recognize the love that you can feel with God. Just saturating and fueling and, you know, just putting people around your life that will fill you with love and joy and peace and grace and all those good things that come from God. But one thing that I wanted to touch bases on is that most of us, like, you know how much you love someone, right? I have a video that I'll be uploading on the topic of love and love fights for what it loves. And that how deep your love is, you know, because you can love people, you know, there's five different kinds of love that I upload them. And I'll post that. But there's five different kinds of love that there is. And it's like, I realized that the depth of your love is when you're like mistreated by somebody or betrayed by someone, or you lose a loved one, or you just have a falling out with someone. What I've recognized is that we can go through different stages, you know, where we want to have revenge or you get angry, you know, or, well, there's like five or four different stages, which is like angry, sadness, acceptance, and then forgiveness, God willingly, that you're filled with forgiveness. But what I realize is that you can go through stages, right? And you can have a petty stage where you're like, oh, I don't want to talk to this person. And I'm going to keep it real with y'all, because I'm very forgiving. I extend grace to everyone. But there's certain people in my life or person that, you know, sometimes with me, it's a little bit more harder to forgive, or not even harder to forgive. It's just like you can try to convince yourself that you forgive them, but then you realize, like, I don't talk to this person. I don't want, like, someone else to talk to this person. Which, it's petty, I realize, or God has shown me, like, really, Esmé. So, revelation the Lord has shown me is that in the time where you're being petty, or let's just say you're mad with someone, and then you don't want your bestest friend to talk to that person. Or if you're not talking to someone, you know, you don't want someone close to you to talk to that person. Which, I've been there, seriously. And it's immaturity. Like, there's no growth, there's no involvement. And what God has been strategically showing me and giving me insight on this topic, you know, how love fights for what it wants and love fights for what it loves. It's like God fights for our love. But in this whole thing, you know, I once reached out and I told someone, like, you know, if you're going to talk to so-and-so, you know, I just feel that I don't want to allow access in my life. So therefore, if you're going to talk to that person, don't talk to me. I literally, like, did something childish like that, you know? And God was like, Esmé, what is your problem? So what I've learned from this is that, think about this. I have made videos on loving others and consistently, like, just loving on others, because we can, like, let's just say you have a falling out with someone and you're not talking to them, or they haven't forgiven you, but you still love them and you still care for them. So you're still praying for them, and you're praying for them consistently. And that's where God has really shown me the depth of love, because you could feel that you're angry with someone, but then when you're praying, like, you lift that person up in prayer, and it's like, you know, Lord, have I forgiven this person? Have I not? But I realized that you love someone, and the depth of your love is how you consistently pray. how you consistently, you know, bring that name to the Lord. And with the month of love, you know, I realized that if someone else can love on someone that you cannot love on, because for some reason, you know, you feel like you're not talking to them. Let's just say you have a falling out with your sister, you have a falling out with your mother, you know, and or you have a falling out with a best friend, or I don't know, whoever it is you're falling out. I don't know, this is for somebody, because I experienced this. And what God showed me was that, like me, I love on strangers, and I'm always stressing, you know, love on this person, because, you know, you don't know who it is you're encouraging. You don't know who it is that you're showing a Christ-like heart to. You could be God to somebody by extending love or generosity to somebody. Because we don't know, you know, we don't know what people need. We don't even know what other people are praying for. But this is what God showed me, is that when you yourself personally cannot love on somebody that you truly do love and you lift them in prayers, if someone else can be that love in their life when you can't, that is exactly what God revealed to me, is that, you know, if you're not talking to someone and you're not forgiving them, you know, and someone else can go and love on them, and you're like, no, don't talk to me if you're talking to that person, because I've been petty like that. I'm keeping it real, because God showed me this. You know, if you can't love on them, or you're not loving on them and you're praying for them, somebody else, or your best friend or your coworker, somebody else that could love on that person, and you're like, no, I don't want you to talk to that person, you know, because you're mad at them, which is so childish. It's really stupid. It's petty. But I was there. And what I want you to recognize is that if you're hindering or trying to hinder someone else loving on someone else, you know, this could be for anybody. I'm just using an example of what God showed me. But let's just say you're at work, you don't want to talk to your boss, and you're like, hey, you know, gossiping or whatever it is, and you don't want someone else to talk to that person. It's petty, but at the same time, you're hindering your blessings, you're hindering prayers. And that's where God has shown me, you know, if you consistently pray for someone and they betray you, treat you in a harmful way, or they're just really out hurting you, and then you want to, like, you know, like, you could pray for them, but then you're kind of like still not in forgiving, like, you're still not forgiving them. Do you understand what I'm saying? I pray that you understand this, but just don't get in the way. If you see someone and you want to love on them, and God puts in your heart a complete stranger, you know, whoever it is that you're praying for, who knows? Because you could be that answered prayer for somebody else, a complete stranger. You can love on them, you know, redirect them back to Christ. And whoever it is that you may be having a falling out with, you know, you miss them and you want to have a relationship with them, but you have pride or ego edging God out to where you don't want to just, you know, admit to them, hey, I'm sorry, or hey, you did something that hurt my feelings and I miss you in my life. And what the point is, that don't hinder other people's blessings. Or if you're praying for someone, it shows the depth of your love. Even though you may not talk to them, you may not see them, if you're praying for them, that just shows that you have a very, very deep love. I think that the greatest thing that we could do for others is pray for them. You know, it goes way beyond money. It goes way beyond anything. When you pray for someone, you're lifting that name to God. And you know that God is a miraculous God and he can do miracles. So whoever it is that is under the sound of my voice, it's not an accident you're watching this video. You know, people tend to do more on Valentine's Day or holidays. But if we were to treat every day like Valentine's Day, if we would extend love, time, you know, generosity, gifts, flowers, any type of love, someone's love language, you know, and the greatest thing you can do is pray for someone. So if you're having a moment where you feel petty and you're like, I don't want to forgive this person, you know, pray for them, pray for yourself more than anything. If you can't forgive someone, or you can't extend grace, love, kindness to somebody else, and then you want to be petty and be like, don't talk to them because I'm not talking to them. I've been there. And what God revealed to me is that, you know, forgive others. You want to be forgiven, forgive others. And if you want love, love others. And I pray in the name of Jesus that this somehow gives you so much insight, revelation, wisdom, knowledge beyond your years of age, for you to recognize that true love comes with sacrifice. And if you have to sacrifice your pride, or you have to sacrifice time to pray for somebody, or you have to sacrifice being kind when you don't feel like you want to, that is the greatest love, is to put your pride aside, pray for somebody, and just really, really extend love to others, especially strangers, because we don't know what people are going through. We don't know who has had falling outs with people closest to them that really need love. So whatever it is, if you're praying for someone that you love and you want forgiveness from, or you're praying for someone that you miss, or you're just praying for someone because God laid it in your heart, there's a reason for that. God's is a strategic, intentional God. If you're praying for someone, God put them in your heart. And if you know someone else can extend love to that person when you cannot, or you are just unable to, just know that you could be that blessing. You could be someone's answered prayer. So I pray in the name of Jesus that this this blesses your life, and that you put your pride aside and just really love on others, because God has not called us to be prideful. He calls us to love on others, and the way he loves us, we should love on others. So I think that's John 15:2. Love others as I have loved you. So I pray that you have an amazing, amazing month, full of love, full of generosity, grace, kindness, unconditional love. And more than anything, that you surround yourself with the Holy Spirit and you fuel your life with the Holy Spirit, because the only way that we can walk around and be in peace, joy, love, and extend all those things to other people is if we allow God to put them in us. So in Jesus' name, I pray that my transparency blesses you. And Esmé, you know, Lord&Esmé does get petty. Not Lord, it's Esmé gets petty, but then God brings her back. Hello. So whatever it is that you're going through, it's not an accident that you're under the sound of my voice. And I pray that my transparency blesses your life. And remember, don't give up. God is at work in your future. Go and read Luke 18. Read some Proverbs or some Psalms, because a brother is made in adversity. When you're going through some problems and you have someone in your life, you know, that is blessing your life, and you're going through a hard time, remember that scripture. I don't know, it's in Proverbs, but it says, a brother is made in adversity. So whatever it is that you're going through, if you have people around you that are loving you and just extending kindness to you and supporting you and holding you accountable for things that you may do, that's why I make my videos, because I want you to know that my pettiness, I pray it blesses, you know, that when God gives me word, that in my pettiness, I just pray that you're blessed and you recognize, hey, you're being petty. Let's not have a pity party. Let's extend love and grace to others. And it's just, and what God really, really revealed to me is that I really had to tell that person, like, hey, thank you for loving on that person when I can't. You know, God really just brought it back and humbled me and said, hey, if you can't, or if you, not saying you can't, I'm not going to say you can't. I'm just going to say, if God has removed someone for your life for a particular season or a particular reason, God will put other people in that person's life to extend love to them. So I just want you to know that if you have someone in your life that you feel like you're mad at because they're not doing for you, or you just feel like, man, they're not taking my side, you know, they never see things the way I want them to, you know, I want you to recognize that God does things strategically. He does things intentionally. And I had to really, like, get my mind right and say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for having someone to love on that person when they're not in my life. And I just want you to know that. Recognize that it's not about us. It's not about you. It's not about me. It's about God and what God is doing. And if you have someone in your life, you've been upset with them because of that, you know, because you feel like, oh, they're talking to that person and they're not, like, doing for me. Recognize this, that God does everything for a specific reason. I believe with Mary and Martha, like, he told, like, God told Martha, that person is not there for you because I intended it to be that way, you know? So if you have someone in your life that you're upset with or anything, or you feel like you're upset with them because they're talking to somebody that you don't want them to talk to, call them and tell them thank you. Thank you for loving on that person when I'm not able to, because it's a blessing. It's a blessing. And I think in that's exactly what God wanted me to learn and to become in that moment where I was having, like, a pity party or just kind of upset or just being dumb for being ignorant or dumb for any stupid reason. So I recognized that God was like, hey, it's not about you. It's not about you. Hello, bring it back. So in that, I just pray that you recognize that if someone else can love on someone else when you cannot, that you you really, really tell God thank you and acknowledge that person. Tell that person, hey, call them, text them, tell them, hey, thank you for being able to love that person when I'm not able to. And just trust in God that he restores relationships and he does the greatest that, you know, anyone can do. He's a miraculous God, and I'm praying for you. I'm in agreement with you and for you, that the desires of your hearts come to pass, and that if there's any relationships in your life that need restoration, that they're going to be restored, and that all the tears that you have, they're going to turn to joy. Because when God is finished with the situation or the season, you're going to see that it had a strategic, intentional reason for whatever pain you've been caused. There's a greater purpose. And through that, you're learning and evolving, and your relationship with God is growing. And with that, you're always learning, living and learning. And I cannot stress enough that God wants you to evolve and grow and exercise that muscle of love, those spiritual muscles of faith, to where you're going to love on others when you feel that it's completely the hardest and most challenging. Is that if you can't love on someone else and someone else is around that person, they're loving on them for you, God hears your prayers and he's answering you abundantly. Trust in him. Love on others when they seem to be unlovable. And I pray that you have an amazing month full of love. And remember, God is at work. This too shall pass. Don't give up, and never give up on loving on others as God has commanded to us. The only reason we're loved and we're secure in him is because he loves us and we trust that whatever he is doing, it's for a season. Everything passes. And I pray in this, in the mighty name of Jesus, that if you're praying for a husband, a wife, restoration of relationships, that this February, you just every day expect it, declare it, and tell the Lord, thank you. And if you've had a falling out because of some complete misunderstanding, make it right. Call the person, you know, ask for forgiveness. I always, you know, in the Bible it says to, you know, apologize even when you're not, like, at fault at times. And I'm not saying consistently putting yourself, that's a completely different video if you're consistently apologizing. No, I'm talking about if it's a mother, a sister, and, you know, you've had a falling out, you know, it happens for a reason. And, you know, like I said, a brother's made in adversity, but, you know, we're not perfect. We extend grace to others. And if you have other people around you that are loving on you when you feel that you miss someone in your life, you know, make it right. And if you can't, if you've tried making it right and it's not working out, then just trust God. Surrender that person to God. And that's where the deepest love comes, is when you consistently pray for that person. And if they have other people in their lives, God will put people in their lives to love on them and to bring them back to God and to remember, you know, hold them accountable. Like, hey, you shouldn't be mad with your mom. You shouldn't be mad with your brother. You shouldn't be mad with your sister. You know, God called us to love each other. And I know at times the people closest to us can hurt us deeply or the most, but love on them, because God calls us to love on others as he loves on us. So I pray in the name of Jesus that you make your wrongs right, and that you really, really recognize that whatever's happening to you, it's not so much about God, who God is using to, you know, hurt you, betray you, or who he's using to reveal to you certain things in your life. What it is who you're becoming out of that. What you do with what has done to you is the greatest, I think, lesson that God wants us to learn, is that you exercise love when it's the most difficult or most challenging. Because once you exercise in love, God can just elevate you and take you to the next place. We're all learning. We're all living and learning. And that's what God wants, to see who you're going to become more like Christ. You're going to become more having that love muscle, to where you can love on others when you're like, oh. So I pray in the name of Jesus, you're blessed. And remember, don't give up. God is at work. I'm in consistent prayers for you for insight, revelation, clarity, wisdom, knowledge beyond your years of age, and much, much, much love, joy, and grace to extend to others as God pours into you. Bendiciones para todos. Happy month of love. I love y'all. And thank you for all your time that you invest. I pray that my time, that the time you spend with me and my videos, it blesses your life. And if you feel led to share, please do. Bendiciones. One more thing. The video got cut off. But I want you to know, for the people that are praying for, the kings and queens that are praying for marriage, restoration of a marriage, family unity, you're praying for a child, a baby, I want you to know that I'm in agreement with you. Wake up every day declaring it. I'm in prayers for you for the month of love, that this month of love will blow you away for 2020. You'll have that spouse, that God submitted and committed spouse that you've been praying for. Let's declare it together. Wake every day and declare and thank God in advance for what it is that you're praying for, that it's already been done and that it's already in the making, what's already been created. So just wake up and declare and thank God for it every day. Let's wake and declare the desires of our heart, and they're done in Jesus' name. Bendiciones para todos. That's the last thing I wanted to share with y'all. Declare it, thank God in advance for it, and that spouse is already made and it's there. So whatever it is that you need, ask God to give you that spiritual discernment and wisdom to recognize your gifts, your spouse, your baby, your family, that career, that dream and desire of your heart.